There was a devotee whose name was Apputhi Adigal in Tamil Nadu. Because he did not know Shiva directly, he started worshipping as Shiva's devotee. Thirunavukkarasar was a great devotee of Shiva. So, Apputhi Adigal, who was a rich man, started worshipping Thirunavukkarasar as an embodiment of Shiva here. So he did much charity, everything he named after Thirunavukkarasar. He built a village tank, Thirunavukkarasar tank. He built a cow shed for the stray cows, Thirunavukkarasar cow shed. He built a temple, Thirunavukkarasar temple. He had four sons. He named them Thirunavukkarasar 1, Thirunavukkarasar 2, Thirunavukkarasar 3, Thirunavukkarasar 4. This is a devotee. They are not reasonable people. So one day, one man came who looked like a Shiva Bhakta with ash on his forehead. He came and asked someone in the town, why is this tank named as Thirunavukkarasar tank? They said, Apputhi Adigal is a great devotee of Thirunavukkarasar, so he calls everything Thirunavukkarasar. All his four children are Thirunavukkarasars. His house is named after Thirunavukkarasar. Everything is Thirunavukkarasar. So this man said, can I meet him? Where does he live? They told him where he is. He went to Apputhi Adigal's house. Apputhi Adigal in the morning, after the cooking is done in the house, he's always waiting outside on the street. Anybody who comes, please, can you come and eat in my house? Anybody who passes this way, can you come and eat in my house? That's his joy. So he was waiting outside. This man came, a Shiva Bhakta. He thought it's a great benediction today that a Shiva Bhakta has come on the road. He welcomed him and took him inside. And he brought all his four sons, introduced them. Thirunavukkarasar 1, Thirunavukkarasar 2, Thirunavukkarasar 3, Thirunavukkarasar 4. His wife took his blessings and they wanted to serve him. He told the eldest boy to go into the garden and cut a plantain leaf and come to eat upon as you're eating here. The boy went out to cut a plantain leaf and when he opened up the tender leaf which is still rolled, when a guest comes of some significance, they don't serve in a leaf which is opened up. They want to take that leaf which is still rolled. So he wanted to cut that one. When he cut that one, a cobra came out of it and bit him in the neck. The boy came running home and in the garden he fell. And when his mother came, he said, a snake has bitten me. And he started frothing in the mouth and collapsed. His wife, totally distraught, called her husband. Apputhi Adigal came and saw. And now, if this news spreads, the Shiva Bhakta will not eat in their house. The whole thing will be, whole hospitality will be gone. So he just took a mat, covered the boy, kept him in the garden. He told his wife, you should not show any sign of your grief. We must serve him first. After he leaves, we will handle our matters the way we have to handle it. The wife also agreed. They went and they prepared everything and they wanted to serve him. He wanted the whole family to come and have the meal with him. Then he asked, where is your eldest boy? Apputhi Adigal said, no, he is gone out, let's have the meal. He said, no. Where is the boy? It looks like you're hiding something. Apputhi Adigal said, nothing to hide, let us eat. And why have you called all these four boys Thirunavukkarasar? That man asked. Then immediately Apputhi Adigal got angry. How dare you ask such a question? Do you know who Thirunavukkarasar is? He's embodiment of Shiva here. You cannot talk like this. Then that man said, I am Thirunavukkarasar. Then they fell at his feet and then Thirunavukkarasar asked, what happened to your son? Then the man said, he was bitten by a snake, but I did not want to disturb the hospitality. We wanted you to eat properly and leave. That is before they know he is Thirunavukkarasar, just some devotee on the road. Then Thirunavukkarasar said, don't you do such a thing, bring the boy here. And using certain siddhi, he relieved the boy of the poison and brought him back to life, blessed them and went. These are different kind of people. They are completely different kind of people. They don't belong to this world. They just have one foot in this world. Their ways and their ways of living, the power with which they existed is completely otherworldly.